first time anything like this had ever happened. And no one knew.
Are your teeth white?
Yep.
So old Leo and Arrow set off for the pointless forest, where all things are pointless and nothing is permanent. And by the way, the distance between the land of point and the pointless forest is directly proportional to the amount of time it takes to sing a song.
Here it comes. Sit beside the breakfast table. Think about the trouble. Pour yourself a cup of tea. Think about the bubbles. You can take your teardrops and drop them in a tea cup. Take them down to the riverside. Throw them over the seaside. Swept up by current. Then take them to the ocean to be eaten by some fishes. Who were eaten by some fishes. Swallowed by a whale who grew so old. And lift his body to the bottom of the ocean. Everybody knows that when a body decomposes, the basic elements should give me back to the ocean. The seed is what I got it. Soon it starts to work. His taste is like a tooth. Down in the pool, scratch the best of bubbles. Here's your brain. Your brain's bigger. And here's my brain. Smaller. Like that small. And here's Dana's brain.
I knew the two travelers reached what appeared to be the entrance.
Why is Mama's brain different color?
I want her to be pretty. But mine's prettier than this.
Once on the other side of the barrier, Oleo and Arrow had their first encounter with the pointless man, or the pointed man, depending upon your point of view. You see, the pointless man did have a point.
You have stripes on yours.
All pointed in different directions.
But mine's even prettier.
A point in every direction is the same as no point at all. And speaking of points, I don't know if you've ever been to a forest.
Here's one.
And one of the first things Oblio and Arrow noticed about the pointless forest was that all the leaves and all the trees had points. And all the trees had points. In fact, even all the trees pointed in different directions. It seemed a little strange for a pointless forest. And when the pointed man disappeared, Oblio and Arrow were left standing alone. What to do next when suddenly they were aware of a strange sound coming in from the north.
Sip-side. Are you mailing it to everyone?
Bees headed straight for them.
Sit beside the breakfast table. Think about the trouble.
But when the bees
pour yourself a cup of tea. Think about the bubble.
Finally into the base of the most unusual rock pile. In fact, the rock man. And the rock man said,
"Say, what's happening with you boys? You look like you're pretty shook up.
You've
been working with the bees."